As we noted earlier in the program, the Bank of Canada will make its next rate decision tomorrow, and economists are widely expecting the bank to lower its key interest rate by 50 basis points. In fact, the chief economist from the CIBC is also arguing a 75 basis point drop could be in the cards as well. To talk about this, we're now joined by Jim Stanford, economist and the director of the Center for Future Work. Jim, always good to see you. Thank you for joining us.
My pleasure, Michael.
So let's begin again with this speculation. A 50 basis point cut is what seems to be the majority opinion. Without a doubt, that's going to help out consumers. But why the need for that right now?
It looks in retrospect, Michael, like the Bank of Canada overdid it with their monetary tightening over the last couple of years. Of course, Canadians have felt the pinch of those repeated high interest rate increases. And now we've seen inflation come down. In fact, come down too far by the Bank of Canada's reckoning. It's now below the bank's 2% target, and it's going to fall further in the months ahead. So to try and offset that that very rapid decline in the rate of inflation, and more importantly, to address some of the macroeconomic weakness that we've seen, very slow growth, rising unemployment, the bank is likely to bring the interest rates down by a supersized reduction tomorrow, 0.5 likely, possibly even more.
Yeah, possibly even more. And, you know, I referenced it a bit off top. It's Avery Schoenfeld from the CIBC. He's the one that believes a 75-point basis cut could also be on the table. Do you agree that would be a wise economic policy for the bank to pursue at this point?
Well, they have to trade off a couple of things. I think it would be appropriate given where the economy is at. The latest inflation reading was 1.6% year over year. And that includes, this is the funny part, that includes the increase in inflation that results from higher interest rates itself. In fact, almost half of that increase results from the impact of higher interest rates on mortgage debt charges, which are included in the consumer price index. So the 1.6%, if you strip out the negative impact of the Bank of Canada's own actions, is even less. It's probably below 1% now. And as interest rates flatten and decline as they are now, that CPI number is going to come down, in the bank's view, too far. They want to keep inflation around 2%. And I think this is evidence that they should cut quickly. On the other hand, there is a kind of psychology at play here. And central banks often don't want to alarm people out there. So it could be that they're thinking, well, 0.75 might make sense, but we don't want to make people think we're heading into a recession or anything. So we'll just do something smaller and get ready to do another rate cut at their next meeting.
Okay, so, you know, let's stick with the more modest then. You know, if the bank is going to try to send a steady as it goes message, let's stick with this prediction of a 50 point basis cut. Because even if that bank rate happens or that dip, it means that it's going to sit at 3.75. You know, for one who pays mortgages, for one who pays for a line of credit, it's not as if their rates are going to drop as dramatically. Can you talk to us a bit about that? Just how much of a relief is this actually going to be?
Yeah, part of it is the relief that people are experiencing right away. So we've already had three rate cuts, a total of 0.75 points. Another 0.5 point tomorrow would make it 4 in a row, 1.25 points. So that's a significant easing already. And if you're in a situation where you have to renew your mortgage now, for example, well, you're very grateful that the rate has come down this far. But then again, there's a bit of an anticipation or psychology effect, as all consumers out there see rates coming down and expect them to come down further. That's going to give them a bit more confidence for spending, undertaking new debt, and so on. The full impact, though, does take time, typically around 18 or 24 months, actually, between a rate cut and the full impact of it on consumer spending, business spending, and so on. So there's still a lot of pain in the pipeline. And think about this, Michael, if indeed you're renewing your mortgage tomorrow, and it was a 3-year term or even a 5-year term, even though rates are coming down now, you're still going to pay a lot more than you were paying. So for a lot of households, the bad news is still in the pipeline. And in that regard, again, it seems the Bank of Canada probably overshot the mark with the tightening that they brought into effect.
Okay, well, let's pick up on that point, though, because when you talk about pain in the pipeline, you know, food prices, housing costs, they have not fallen in tandem with the inflation rate that we saw. Should the government be doing something to complement in addition to what's coming from the Bank of Canada.
Oh, you're 100% right. I think it's a big mistake to think inflation is just a monetary policy issue and it's all up to the Bank of Canada. We should have, I think, had a more balanced and multidimensional approach to controlling this inflation all along, including measures, obviously, in the housing market. And indeed, high interest rates have made the housing price increases worse, partly because of those debt charges that I mentioned, also because of the slowdown in housing construction. I mean, everyone in Canada agrees we need more housing supply, but what does high interest rates do to the construction industry? It hammers them. We're getting less housing supply. So in the housing sector, the Bank of Canada's medicine has been perverse. And I think we needed measures in other parts of the economy as well, including competition measures in some of the industries that clearly took advantage of the pandemic to jack up prices too far. We could have had, I think, a bit more relief for low-income Canadians. We had a GST credit for a while, but I think we needed more of that to help low-income Canadians through this, rather than just saying it's up to the Bank of Canada, they'll do the job.
Okay, but you're using the word needed in past tense. How about going forward? Do you think a remedy is needed now or the time has passed for that?
Oh, well, first of all, I think we should take some lessons from this experience. Another lesson, Michael, is that we should have, I think, been a bit more patient about the whole thing. Most of the decline in inflation that we've seen, inflation's come down as fast as it went up. And most of it had nothing to do with the Bank of Canada and the interest rates. Most of it had to do with the repair and supply chains after the COVID lockdowns, the retreat in energy prices after the oil price shock of 2022 after the invasion of Ukraine, and a normalization of profitability. When inflation was very high in 2022, that's when corporate profits were at their absolute highest. There's a clear link between corporate profit taking and that inflation. And most of those things would have solved themselves anyway, certainly the supply chains and the oil price crisis and so on. So I think in retrospect, we should have, I think, been a bit more patient rather than throwing the whole economy into neutral, which is where we are. We've been kind of dancing along the edge of a recession for the last year. So I think we could have, I think, managed it a bit better. Going forward, I do think we have to, again, learn the lesson. Inflation is a multidimensional problem and it needs a multidimensional solution. It's not just because, you know, Canadians have too much spending power, as the conventional theory goes. There's a lot of factors that go into inflation and government has to tackle them all.
Jim Stanford, always appreciate the time. Thank you for that.
Thank you, Michael.